Well, hey there team, and welcome back to the channel, and welcome to SNKRX, or perhaps SNKRX. I can't be 100% sure, but I think SNKRX is what I've heard other people call it. This game, oh, I'm happy I found this one. So it's in the sort of burgeoning auto battler scene, which is my sort of kind of favorite upcoming genre that we're seeing more of these days, right? Loop Hero's got some of it in it. Despot's game, still forthcoming, but there's a demo you can check out. That's really cool as well. And of course, you've got the auto chesses and that sort of stuff, right? These things seem to have expanded out of these reverse tower defense, bloody Clash of Clans style sort of. Well, no, is it Clash of Clans? Is that the one? Or the one where you send waves from. It's just PvP two dudes that send waves after each other. Or it might be their sister game. I can't remember. Apologies. Anyway. So it's really unusual. It focuses more on the sort of tactical building minutia as opposed to the point of contact where most of gameplay loops are, in like a first-person shooter or something like that, right? So anyway, what happens in this is you build a little party of warriors and healers, and they're all very cute and colored, rogues and that sort of stuff, and then they're in your snake in their walking order, and you drive your snake around the arena, and, you know, maybe the warrior, if the enemies get close, he makes an area of effect thing that can stun dudes, or maybe the mage shoots a little fireball and that sort of stuff. So you drive your little snake around the arena for, like, 15 seconds, kill all the dudes, try and survive to the higher difficulty, and then you have the robust sort of upgrade system, which is where you build your party out. We'll go straight into arena run. I actually played a bit of this last night. I meant to, you know, dip my toe, and then I played it probably for an hour or something like that. Anyway, so this is where we start. This is sort of your board of what you can buy. You only have three things. You can re-roll it for $2, but we only start with three gold, right? We can lock the selection like that, which would mean that once we come back from the arena, it holds these. So maybe there's something here that you want to buy, but you can't afford. There's also this shop. Now the shop, as I understand, graduates on its own. See, it's got XP points, but you can sink $5 in to buy an XP point to then level it up. And you can see all that really does is it changes the chance of different tier level party members that you can get. So at the moment, we can't physically get tier 4 at all. It will not occur, it will not show up in our shop, whereas it's 70% chance of tier 1. I think if you go high enough, it might actually abolish tier 1 altogether. I can't be sure. I'm still working it out, right? You can also go up here and pull up a guide. It explains a lot. You obviously just left and right to turn your bloody snake. If you buy multiple versions of, see, like a level 1 swordsman, he'll turn into a level 2, and then 3 2s will turn into a 3, so getting him to level 3 is significantly difficult. But you can see down the bottom, there's the grayed out effect cleave, and it's highlighted here. So you can get this super version. You can't have multiple swordsmen in your party, but you can have them side by side. If you have played Battle Chess or Auto Chess or whatever, I think Ubisoft's got one that I played as well, the Heroes of Might and Magic one. This is all sort of old hat. This is becoming an established genre, but there's a chance that this is the first time some of you have ever seen this before. Now you have a look at this warrior. This will be his sort of subclass. We might be able to see that better if we mouse over. Yeah, actually there's a swordsman there, exactly. So this is sort of his designation. Up here, you mouse up here, you can see what he actually does. Deal 11 damage to an area with extra damage for more dudes. So you kind of want to drive him into the bloody blob, right? Whereas he actually contributes to this synergy. And you can see it says 3/6. It's separated into its columns, right? So this will be 2/4. And this will probably be 3 of them. 2, 4, 6. Yeah. So if I get 3 warrior bonuses in my party, I will get a blanket passive to my party, which is +50 defense or +25 defense to all allied warriors, right? And he's under the category that is warrior, this thing. All right. It might be a bit to take on. It's probably worth grabbing the psychic. I'm still learning, alright? There's a lot of builds, a lot of synergies, a lot of ways to go about synergy. But the fact that he's $2 shows us that he's a tier 2, and as we saw before, there's only a 20% chance you get given a tier 2. So we might capitalize on the psychic. You can see, creates a small area that deals 13 AoE damage, right? So there we go, there's our little party, that's him there. And then we've got Sorcerer, and we've got Psyker, right? Now, we could probably win with that one dude, but maybe we buy another bloke. Maybe we buy Oh, minus enemy defense. So if you fill out the mage tree, it strips the enemy. Let's do that. And you can change your running order, right? So maybe you don't want to put the magician in the front. Maybe you want to put the psychic in the front. Anyway, let's go. The music is to die for as well. And all you do is just drive around. You can ram into dudes. I'm not sure if that's what you are supposed to do with some of these guys. But you can see they're both actually putting up little squares. That's cool. There's guys that spawn little creeps. There's saboteurs. They throw a little bomb and they're like, oh, got a little sound effect. There's a like a hunter that can spawn a pit and it barks like a dog. A little circle flies out, that sort of thing. There's actually, in the really basic art style, between that and little sound bites, they've come up with some really unique and clever ways of doing characters. Now, it's also worth pointing out, there's a thing to the economy. You get one interest per 5 gold, up to a maximum of 5, right? So if you sit on 25 bucks, you potentially earn a passive income of 5 bucks per round. So trying to save up and sit on money is another consideration. The merchant here, I believe, is a dud character. He doesn't do anything. Like, see here, Chronomancer. I like the Chronomancer. He doesn't actually do anything, but he buffs the team. Plus 20% attack speed to all allies, right? Whereas the merchant does plus 1 interest for every 10 gold, up to a max of 10 from the merchant, right? So this guy can actually give you a pretty compounding sort of financial back. And it's sort of one of those things, you want him taking up one of the seats so as to make more money. And I don't know, maybe we give that a go, right? And if you fill out the merchant tree, there's a chance for enemies to drop gold on death, right? I like the Chronomancer quite a bit, but we can't afford him because I went and bought him because I'm an idiot. But that's okay. Maybe we just go. We just go. I thought about locking it for a second. Like I said, this is more, I'm not trying to tell you the bloody min-max big brain strategies of this game. Also, it was, I believe this is like $3. So, I don't really see an excuse not to buy this. That white dude back there is a turret. Like, he will shoot, yeah. You start to, if I kill one of the green dudes, it aggroes all the other blokes. We're gonna see this in a sec, I think. You see it like that? So you can bash into them and they get knocked away. And they're usually worse for wear than you are. So I guess maybe there is a strategy from ramming. Now, this is interesting. None of these are overtly going to see how it's flashing. Oh, actually, no. Arcanus will add to this. Sorcerers repeat their attacks once every attacks. Ooh, that's not a bad little synergy. The fact that we can get that up, we should do it even just to showcase it, right? So you can see now it's highlighted blue. And you can see sorcerers repeat their attacks every 4 attacks. And who have we got in the sorcerer category? It's this guy here. And this guy here. Maybe we put them both at the front. All right. Let's go. Maybe we'll just save our money. So you could probably, yeah, sorcerer, because it takes 2 is probably something worth trying to synergize early. Oh, wow, look at that. That must have been his double attack every 4 attacks, whatever. Hang on, there's one more. 1, 2, 3. Let's see if he shoots 2 fireballs next. Well, yeah, there we go. So that's the sorcerer synergy hard at work. That's cool. Now, we have to pick an item. Ballista. Plus projectile damage. Now, see, I don't think they technically shoot projectiles. Launches projectiles. Creates a small area that deals AoE. Okay, hang on. Position 4 has plus 30% damage. When an ally dies, it explodes, launching enemies away. See, this is a pretty handy all-around bonus, but I think actually, because it doesn't really synergize with anything, I think it might be a bit of a trap. I'm still working that out. Sometimes you'll get like attack speed in slot 3 or whatever. I feel like this might be the go. plus projectile damage. Let's do that. So now what we can actually do is, again, I think this has a shop's experience system here. See, the shop has one XP. So I'm not sure what's dictating the shop gaining XP other than it might be just round based. So I think the shop will level up as you do the run and the money is just to speed the leveling process. Perhaps the same is said here about that. Plus 20% projectile damage. Interesting. This is cool as well. You can see this little nub here. It indicates that we already have an Arcanist and this will contribute to upgrading. So we'll do that. And you can see there, we still only have one Arcanist, but we have one bonus. It's almost like an XP for him sitting there. If we were to buy another level one Arcanist, they will fold into a level two, right? Chronomancer I really like, plus he's gonna help synergize with these mages. But what was his bonus? Plus 20% attack speed to all allies. Yeah, I like that. I like that. Now the cleric we could get as a healer, probably not a bad idea. Let's do it. It doesn't overtly synergize with anything, strictly speaking, but having heals isn't necessarily a bad thing either. Anyway, I love this game. See that blue, the blue dude drops that little, he drops like this little nub on the ground. So they're called special attacks, I think, and there are some debuffer classes that will neuter their special attacks, which especially the blue attack, when you get a lot of those blue guys shooting those little pellets do a lot of damage. So having someone that can counter that is pretty cool. Now look, we've got a tier 3 in here with the host. Periodically spawns a small critter, and then you've got Swarmer. Now I know we don't really have the synergy for it, but I want the host. I think he's kind of cool. Let's maybe try and build towards that if we can help it. Now what's going on here? We could synergize with the Psyker. Damage and attack speed per active set to allied Psykers, plus 10% to allied Psykers. Who's the other Psyker? Psychic. Now I'm assuming this is, I'm assuming that's what this is, an active set there. Are we at 7 yet? I think we are. So if we try and, we're at party max. So what I might do, I might actually get rid of the merchant because we're not really playing a big brain money strategy at the moment. Let's add that. So now we've got two active sets. But it doesn't really, it doesn't say. Yeah, that's okay. But yeah, I get the feeling that's how that works. And then we'll get the cleric upgrade. $4. Yeah, look, we're getting shop XP. Yeah, not clear what some of the XP, there's my little critter. Out you go, little buddy. I always enjoy pet builds and things like Diablo and all that. Diablo 3, I probably play the Witch Doctor the most. Mostly because he's such a meme. You get these really self-serious emo people like, I'm going to play the wizard and and be an elf of all fucking things. I don't know if there's elves in Diablo, actually, but my point is, you know, they get their bloody 30-second Smaz cosplay going, and then I rock up with a class that vomits on people and throws bloody poison frogs at them. Okay. Hunter? Arcanist, let's go. There we go, now we got a level 2 Arcanist. Level 3, what happens here? Plus 50% attack speed for the orb and 2 projectiles are released per cast. That's kind of cool. So what we might do is sit on that $10, actually, because that should give us that interest of 2, right? We can sit on it, we're not struggling. We're not struggling with this run. Oh wow, this is a boss. And if we don't kill him, they will just keep spawning adds. So you gotta try and bully him if you can help it. Oh damn it. Yeah, something died in there. That's what one of my dudes died, but that's okay. We're all right. This music has got me bloody going. So that was a bit tougher, you know? Death 6. Now, I'm not sure what this does. Position 6 takes 10% of its health as damage every 3 seconds, right? So maybe there is some necromancy, there's some sort of big brain thing going on there, but I don't know what it is yet. Centipede makes us move faster. I think we'll take that. We'll take that. Is this getting XP at all? It's not, so we might actually have to manually pay that in. Let's buy another Arcanist. I kind of like a little setup so far. All right, let's give it another. I'm just going to go dry again, bloody like a gentleman. See if we can get up to that 25. You know, just get a little bit of breathing space to have that economy flesh out. Look at that. We're doing all right. Oh, those bloody blue things, man. Oh, stuff. Wave 4 or 5. Okay, all right. Oh, wow. They're dumping on me. Stuff it. Run away. Jeez, we've taken some damage. Oh, my goodness. I thought that was it. Oh, no. We've only got a couple of tricklers at the end. Okay. Got a bit sweaty there. You can see all the health of the dudes down the bottom. My little bloody tic-tac tablet dudes. Arcanus, let's go. Let's go. That'll turn into a 2 and then we'd have to make another 2, I think. Psychic. Okay, yeah. Um, 28. How stingy do we want to be? What if I do a reroll? Oh, now that's interesting. Look at this. Mage minus enemy defense. There's room for potentially getting that synergy. Thief, look at this. A tier 4 has appeared. But he won't bloody synergize with anyone. And then that's when the quest, it's like, oh, what do we do here? Because you have to look up here. What are the chances of getting a tier 4? It's 5%. You know, do we pivot here? What do we do? Yeah, he has literally no synergies. He would have with the mercenary. All right, so they're good. Hang on. Those ones I really don't want to hurt if I can help it. I wouldn't mind getting the wizard involved, which means maybe these blokes at the end. The host. Oh, I really don't want to get rid of him. The cleric, getting rid of my healer is probably not the brightest idea I've ever had. Let's do it. Let's get rid of him and we'll get the thief. All right. I quite like the rogue classes. See, it throws a knife that chains. I think that's so cool. I'm assuming the knife counts as a projectile, but I'm not sure. It might just be the slow moving. Yeah, it says slow moving orb that launches projectiles, right? So, you know, some of the language is a little bit too cryptic, if you ask me. What's the wizard do? Shoots projectiles that deal AoE damage. I mean, I'd like that. I would like that. Maybe we just go with this for the moment. Oh, because of the synergy. The synergy. I want the synergy. And then what's the mage one? Yeah. Swarm. No, I'm not doing it. I wanna. There will be more things, you know, I don't want to get bogged down. But I don't believe there's a master list of all the different classes, right? So I'm sure there's a whole bunch of classes that I've never even seen before. But I have to wonder, like take the swordsman synergy, for example, where you want to get 6. Are there six tier 5 options? I don't think so. Uh-oh. Oh, wow. Your dudes respawn and you don't lose them, so it's not, you know, as long as you make it through the wave. See, like these, they have like 6 synergy. So I wonder, what happens when we get up to the point where it actually inverts and tier 1 becomes rare? Is it, you know, like, how do you know you're going to be able to hit those synergies? So I feel like there's an actual back to front strategy potentially baked in there, where you maybe want to milk all the tier 1 stuff, right? Yeah. I don't suppose there's a... No, I don't think so. Like a master list? That'd be pretty cool. However, this merchant's going to synergize really well with our tier 4 thief, so maybe we embrace the shift, right? I really want to keep that swarmer, but I don't know. Mage. That's this one here. Plus 20% attack speed to all allies. That's pretty good. All right, maybe we get rid of you and we'll buy the merchant. And now we have enemies can drop gold on death, which, you know, that's pretty handy. Get the old vagrant. I want to get the move speed. Right, see, I have to buy another one. There we go. Now we're talking. But let's try and keep it above 25. I'll do a reroll. Let's go. Interesting. Oh, here we go. Perfect. Vagrant upgrade. Nice. And then we've got a chronomancer. Look at this spellblade looking dude. Nice. It's probably worth locking, actually, because I'll get the chronomancer upgrade, I think. All right, let's go. Oh, much faster. Anyway, like I said, I'm showcasing this. I'm not trying to tell you this is the best way to play it or anything, but I kind of like that. Do you chase the tiers? Do you try and get the sort of the racial bonus? You know, the 3 pip or the 6 pip thing. Do you get a whole bunch of level 1 ones? Right. You know, so like the warrior, 3 out of 6 will get you the first tier upgrade. So maybe you want to get a bunch of them, or maybe you want to go all out and have a warrior only squad. Oh man. Maybe you need to balance with healers to synergy be damned, because we're starting to get pumped here. Oh, this is not good. Oh no. You bounce off the wall and you reverse direction in a pretty bad... I think I'm fucked here. I don't think I can do this. Oh no. Let's just bloody end it, eh? Straight in front of the traffic. Oh, almost. Anyway, look, we're probably not going to squeeze another run in there, but that I think that gives you an idea of what you're in for with this game. It's addicting as crack, I assume. but like I said, it's $3 or something like that. This game's a bloody steal. I'm probably going to play it all day, so I thought I'd make a video of it to shout out. Let me know what you reckon, team. Let me know if this appeals to you. Maybe you end up picking it up. Maybe you came here to see what this game was about. I don't know. Let me know, though. That makes my day the most, is when I can show someone a cool little game they didn't know about, and then maybe they go and get it on the back of that. That I would like to hear about, for sure. All right, team, thanks again for joining me. I might just leave it there for the time being, and I'll catch you guys on the next one.